Hello and welcome to Chair Interval Training, brought to you by Community Access Yellow Springs and the Yellow Springs Senior Center. And I'll be your instructor. My name's Lynn Hardman. I am a certified silver sneakers, I love silver sneakers, flex instructor. Today, what you'll need for this stand up, sit down, fight, modify, adapt, but never give up exercise program is yourself and a sturdy chair. Now, in addition to that, if you have it, a flexible rubber tubing or flat rubber band and some hand weights. I have these pre-made 3 to 4 pound sock weights that we used last week, but if you didn't join us last week, I'm going to show you how you could make that. Mine happen to be stuffed with rice and it's loose, not in a bag, so that I can use it in the microwave as a little neck warmer or muscle warmer or tummy bag when I'm feeling bad. But if you had, let's say, a bag of lentils or brown or rice and an old, long, tightly woven, mostly cotton, if you want to put it in the microwave, no holes, tube sock, you can make your own hand weights with a couple of pounds to as many as 4 pounds with plenty of room to tie it off and use as a hand weight. And the reason this is so good is, let's say you have arthritis or you just want to drape it over your arm or your leg. If you've got a pound on each side of the sock, voila. Okay, so that's an idea, a little project for you at home, but let's get started, shall we? Before you do, make sure that you've consulted your physician before you begin any new exercise program, and you check in with yourself. If you are feeling dizzy or out of balance at any time, it's recommended you remain in the chair. You'll get plenty of benefits from the exercise there, or return to your chair. Make sure you got a safe area, free and clear of things that might get underfoot. You got some water, and we'll play some music and just move our bodies. Let's start with a gentle, gradual warm-up. Pay attention to your body. If anything hurts, don't do it. All right. We've got some Motown music as kind of a tribute to the Supremes and Mary Wilson, a fabulous Motown musician, vocalist who passed away this last week. Boo-hoo. All right. So, whether you're seated or standing, elongate your spine. This long spine and best posture with ears over shoulders over hips will make it much easier to move your body. And that's one of the goals of this program, is to make our movements easier. Yes. Also, when we elongate our spine, whether we're seated or standing, stretching the crown of our head up to the ceiling, it makes more room for our lungs to do their job. So, breathe, inhale, exhale, repeat at your own pace. Start with a basic march, taking those arms through a comfortable, small range of motion. And then gradually, if it feels good, you can bring them into a bigger range of motion. Always, always stay in your chair or close enough that you can touch it to check your balance should you feel out of kilter. Because we are going to work on the ABCs. Agility, balance, coordination, plus some cardiovascular, that is aerobic training, and strength training. And we'll end up with some flexibility and relaxation. Yes, you could choose to do it all or just parts. Okay? Take your stance a little wider and just rock your body right and left, kind of flexing down into those hips and knees and ankles. And breathe, of course. We're going to do a little disco warm up. As you pulse to the right, I want you to think, point up to the right. You got your chair on the left if you need. Let's try that. Point. Point. You can look or not. You look straight ahead. Now we're going to point up to the right and down to the left. Does that look like a disco move? Already you're doing some coordination. Awesome. Let's add on to our little disco warm up. Just march it out and roll your hands. Take it over to the other side. Let's rock our body to the left. Make sure you can touch that chair with your right. Now we're gonna point up to the left. And then point down to the right. If you want, you could follow that with your eyes. If you get dizzy though, just look straight ahead. Good, just march it out and roll those fists. Let's do it one more time. On the right, rock right and left. Point up to the right and down to the left. Good, march it out and roll it out. Over to the left. Got it? Rock left. Good, point up left, down right. Just having fun as we gradually warm our bodies up. Roll it out with that march. Let's stay right behind our chair. Nice wide stance. Sink down into a little mini squat. Keep your head and chest up. Ah, good. I hope it feels good. Now, see how it feels to push up to the balls of your feet and your tippy toes. And if it's great for you, reach up right and left. If you're rock solid, steady with your balance, how about both? Just four more times, warming up those calves, hips, and knees. Ooh, good. March it out again. I want to preview a couple patterns we're going to use today to help us work on balance. We've done these before, but it never hurts to revisit. Stay behind your chair, but I'm going to come out to the front so you can see what I'm doing with my feet. Don't worry about those stops in the music. They're just there. So we're going to do our skate fly pattern, where we cross our foot slightly behind the other. If you're behind your chair, you can hold your chair, and then we fly with our heels up. If you're behind your chair, you can hold it up. And then we break it down to four of each. Four skates, four flying. You can hold your chair or raise your arms. Then break it down to twos. Right? Whoops. Skate for two. Fly for two, and eventually we'll break it down to one of each. So skate, fly, and then we have to balance, especially if we slow it down. Let's try that. Slow and slow. We'll do that a little both ways, but I just wanted to preview it to you. Another pattern we're gonna do, and again, you're behind your chair, but I want you to see this, get it into your mind. We're going to do a single double pattern where we just do a single knee lift and then a double. And then we'll be balancing on that double. So you'll want to use your chair and you want to be off to the side. Well, we use lots of different body parts. We might do hamstring curls, hips, leg extensions or little kicks. And we might do it at different paces. So we could go quicker, step, step, lift. Single, double. Single, double. Single, double. We might even be able to go faster. Single, double. Single, double. Get it? We're just warming up, so I don't want to go too fast yet. Why don't you come have a seat? We will continue to warm up with some dynamic stretches. Before we do, let's line those heels up really close to the chair legs so we don't fall as we sit down. Keep your weight equal on both feet. Keep that head stretching for the stars. Get your hips back. Ooh. And come up if you want, or just stay seated. But practice getting those hips back while the head and chest stay up. Now, when we're seated, that is the best time to get stuff down low like your water. And the best way to do that is to first know where you put it. Oh, it's right behind me. Oh, here's to When we're seated, it's the best time to get your water. I hope you're having a little fun. All right, so when you're getting things down low or behind you in your chair, you can step inside and lean to the side and support your spine, and that's a lot easier on your lower back than leaning too far forward and lowering your head below the level of your heart. Okay, now let's get to the front edge of the seat where we can actively sit tall and open this chest up with a deep inhale through our nose, gentle stretch of the chest and shoulders, and then close, pulling the navel in. Ooh, just like a cow with a sway back as we inhale, and exhale like a cat arching their back. And let's get our legs moving, shall we? Sitting tall again. Buckle up your safety belt as you stretch out your right and your left leg. Right and left. Good. If it feels good, try showing the sole of your foot to me. I can't see. Oh yes. Okay. No gum on the bottom of your shoe. That's good. Maybe a little, well, hopefully no snow or ice. All right. Now, let's reach with the opposite arm. Hold the navel in. Squeeze those long, strong quadricep muscles. And remember to keep your back stretching up and lengthening your spine. Pulling the navel in. Good. Getting an active calf and hamstring stretch just a little with this movement, dorsiflexing the foot. Let's do it one more each side. And then just stretch out that right leg and see how it feels with our weight on this left lap. Hinging forward halfway. Reaching forward, reaching the tailbone back. Breathe at your own pace, move at your own pace. Lift the toes and fingers. Feel a good stretch, nothing should hurt. And just move your fingers and toes out and in, or out away from the body, toward, as if you're waving. Now, push that toe toward the floor and pull the navel in as you lean back. Gentle, flowy circles with that ankle rotating one way and then in the other. Good. Let's try those stretches on the other leg. Left leg extended, long, strong torso supporting on the right. Take a little bit of a bow, but not too far. Lift the toes and the fingers. Uh-oh, there's my mark that we're supposed to be starting on the next interval. So don't rush, just wave side to side, and then push that toe down toward the floor. Hold the navel in as you lean back, stretching the back of the hip here if it feels good. And if it doesn't, while you're painting circles with your left toe, one way and the other, you could, if you wanted, put it down on the ground if that hip does not like that flex position. Now, speaking of making this workout yours, we're going to use a scale of 1 to 10 for our intensity level. 1 is the lowest intensity. 10 is way too much. We're going to shoot for a target of 4 to 8. 8 is a little too much. It means you have to slow down. 4 is just right. 5 is great. 6 and 7, super de duper. But you got to be able to talk. So I'll ask you several times, like right now, how do you feel on that scale? 1 to 10? Maybe a 2? Maybe a 3? You know you. If you want to remain in your chair, you're already there. If you want to be on your feet, we're going to do our skating and flying. So you'll want to be positioned safely behind your chair. Plenty of room so you can take your right foot and your left foot. Good. Just 4 more like this. Now lift your heels out to the side. Keep your body tall, whether you're seated or standing. 4 more. 3, 2, skate. You can make it more athletic as needed for your abilities. And lip. Or you could keep your hands on that chair the whole time, but pull your navel in, stretch your spine, and do your best. If you want more, get low, get wide. That's a big leg workout. Now, fly. If you want more, come up to the tippy toe. Dorsiflex those feet. Yes, skate. Last set of 8 skates. 4, 3, 2, fly. 8. Excellent. 4, 3. Now skate 4s. 4, 3, 2, fly. This is a great aerobic pattern. Skate, whether you make it small or large, it's good for your heart and your balance. 4s. Good, up high. One more set of 4. Fly. Let's take it to 2s. Skate for 2, fly for 2. Skate, fly. Remember you got your chair. Skate, fly. One more set of 2s. Now down and up. Skate, fly. Keep the body straight and tall. Good, how about 4 more of these? 4, 3, 2. Now let's slow it down. Skate and fly and skate and fly. Even slower. Skate, 2, 3, 4, fly, 2, 3, 4. Did you feel that in your hip? How's your intensity? 1 to 10. Can you talk? I hope so. We're going to do that again. This time we'll start with our left foot. Right, left. Here we go. Left. We're skating. Get with me now. 4 more. 3, 2. Fly. Left and right. Got it? 4, 3, 2. Skate. Oh, I pointed the wrong direction, but you know what I meant. 4, 3, 2, fly. Make it big or little, but just make it. 4, 3, 2, skate. Last set of 8s with the skating. And last set of 8 with the flying. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, skate. 4, 3, 2, fly. Good, skate. Fly. One more set of 4s, 4 skates, 4 flies. How about 2s? Down for 2, up for 2, again, 2s. Couple more times, doubles. Good. Last set of 2 each. Now down and up. 1 here, 1 here. With me? Are you with me? Do your best. 4 more. 4, 3. Then we'll slow it down. 2, 1. Now slow. Slow skate. Slow fly. Slow skate. Slow, even slower. Hold it. 4, 3. Got your chair. Good. Hold it. Fly. 3, 2, 1. How'd you do with that? I'm a little breathy. How about you? Well, if you need to take a break, take a break. If you want to continue, this time we're going to start with 1s and we're going to build up to 8s. When we get to 8, we're going to balance on the last 4. It'll kind of look like this. When we get to 8, it'll look like this. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get it? If not, we'll get there together. So we're gonna start with, let's start with 2s, all right? And we'll work our way up to 4s. And then to 8s, and then we'll break it down to 8s with balance. Right? Raise our right foot first. Skate for two. Skate. Fly for two. Let's hold this doubles pattern for a while until everybody's on the same boat. Excellent. Two more of these in twos. Good. Last set in twos. How about four of each? Four, three, two, up. Four, three, two, down. Skate for four. Fly. Four. Excellent. Let's do two more sets in fours. In fours. Last set in fours. Excellent. Now eight. Skate for eight. Seven. Six. Five. No balance yet. Fly. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. Skate. We're still not going to balance yet. We're just working our heart and lungs and our leg strength. Fly. Remember, you can make it little, but just move. Four more. Three. Two. Let's add that balance component on the last four. Are you ready? Hold it here. Four. Three. Two. Now, let's skate. Hold it here. That wasn't quite right. Let's do that again. Skate. Hold it. Four, three, two. Let's skate again. Just hold this skating pattern for a while. Hold it here. Balance. Again. Skate. 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 Hold it here. Woo! One more time with the skating. Hold it here. Oh, ready to fly? Woo. Hold it. Four, three, two. Other side. Hold it. Four, three, two. Fly up. Good. Hold it. Three, two. Woo. Again. Hold it. One more time. Hold it. Woo! Do you feel that in your hips? Probably you do. So let's give them a little gentle stretch as we catch our breath, assess our perceived exertion or intensity level. Remember, we're shooting for a happy medium or being able to talk but feeling a little bit like we did something. All right, let's finish this off. We've got about another minute to keep our heart ticking. You can go at your own pace, but let's build it back up to, or build it back down for eights. Ready? Eight skates, right foot, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, fly, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, skate, four, four, three, two, fly, four, good, skate, two, fly, two, good, one of each, whoop, awesome, one of each. This time after four, we're gonna freeze, four more, three, now we're gonna two, freeze here. See if you can hold it. Good. Freeze in your skate pose. Excellent. Let's see if we can freeze in our skate pose on the other side. Easy. And then freeze in our flying pose. Good. How are you feeling? Are you ready to transition to some strength work? We're going to be using our sock weights. If you don't have those, use your body weight, use your mind, create tension, because that's what leads to strength improvements. And your best body weight strength exercise is your squat. So get your feet close to your chair, keep your head up and chest too. Spot a point on the wall across from you if it'll help. And see if you can hover with your weight equal in right and left feet. And then push up, driving your hips forward and squeezing your glutes together. Letting your hips push back, keeping your weight in your heels and all parts of your feet. Do your best, maybe four more, or have a seat. And remember, when you're ready to get your water, make sure you're stepping to the side, leaning to the side, and supporting your spine with these braced abdominals while you breathe, and with bracing with your arm as well. Now, hydration equals happiness. We're gonna do three different exercises with our hand weights. If you don't have these soft weights and it's hard for you, just use your body weight, it's okay. I'm gonna show it seated and then standing. Standing adds a much greater element of balance, and strength is balance and balance is strength. So I'll show it first in the chair. You'll need two weights. So I got these. You can drape it over your wrist, or you can drape it one over the back of your ankle and scooch to the right side of your chair. And you can have the other one in your right hand. Pull your elbow to your belly button, hinge forward, and lift your heel to your hip and your hand to your shoulder. If you get crampy in the hamstring, that's not unusual. You could just leave that foot on the ground. Now, if you're standing, that weight will probably stay there. If you're good at this, and it takes practice. Keep the knee down on that right leg. Keep the chest up. And keep that right elbow pinned to your body. Keep working till you feel like you're stopping. I'm gonna show you what it looks like from the side. That's deceptively hard, folks. Okay, now if you're seated, you're gonna have to lean over in your seat. If you're standing, you'll have to lean over too. We're gonna do a hip abduction. Pull the navel in with a side lateral raise. Ooh, I'm gonna lose my weights. Sometimes you might also, but don't worry. You can hold a weight in your hand, or just use the weight of your leg, and that will be plenty. I see what's happening. I don't have it quite right. Do your best. I like to try different exercises to see what works best for you. Now, last exercise, whether you're seated or standing, will be a front lateral raise with that weight on the front of our ankle, front of our arm, standing tall. Same side, pull the navel in, keep the body still, and breathe. Small range of motion, very hard. We're balancing while we do this. Good, keep going if you like. I'm gonna show what that looks like in the chair. And we'll do this on the other side. So here is the front lateral raise with the leg extension, strengthening the shoulders and the leg quadriceps and hip flexors. And in the chair, here's what that hip abduction with the side lateral raise look like. We're also using our torso a lot here. Support on that left arm. Those are very tricky exercises. I hope you're able to follow along. We'll do the left side just as we did the right, unless you don't want to. But in the meantime, grab both weights. Get your hips back in your chair. Dig your heels in right smack dab against the front legs of your chair. Get your tailbone back and your nose forward, and dig your heels into the ground while you keep your arms extended, weights hanging. We've added a little weight to our squat with these two weights in our hands, haven't we? But if you want to add another exercise, lift it up to about shoulder height. It's our kettlebell swing. Or better yet, let's do our upright row. It's your choice. I'm going to do one of each. The upright row works more of the rear shoulder muscles, and the kettlebell swing works more of the front and medial shoulder muscles. One more of each. Woo! And take a break. How are you doing with your intensity? That little bit right there, even with 3 to 6 pounds, can be aerobic. So let's set ourselves up to succeed in our best way on the left side. Bicep and hamstring curls, side lateral raise and hips, and then front lateral raise and leg extensions. So I'm gonna scooch over to the left side of my chair. Those of you who know you wanna be standing, sidle up to the left, make sure you've got your right hand on the chair. And then balance that weight on the back of the ankle in your chair. Pull the navel in, hinge halfway forward, and let's pin that elbow to the torso and lift. This is a small movement. Remember, if you feel crampy, you can stop. Just do the arm movement. Hamstrings are a little tricky like that, I understand. If you're standing, good on you. If you're seated, good on you too. Okay, transition, leaning a bit to the side, whether you're standing or seated. Try to dorsiflex that foot and lift, lift. This is a small range of motion. Pull that navel in, supporting the spine, leaning over. Do your best. If it hurts, remember, modify, adapt, do a different exercise or just wait. Good, all right. Sitting or standing tall, front lateral raise. This one's hard. I'm gonna put both legs on the platform of my chair. Extend, and remember, you could make it easier by bringing the weight up closer to the shoulder or up closer to the knee, okay? Those are adaptations, choices you can make. Sitting tall, lift. With the weight out here at the end of our arm and our leg, it doesn't take a lot of repetitions before I get tired. How about you? You should feel like dull, icky, burning sensation in the target muscles, but you should never have a sharp, sudden shooting pain. You should just feel like that's enough. One more set of squats, if you wish, or just pretend you're gonna squat. Get your hips well back in your chair, grab both your weights, or neither, or just one, and grab them palms down, shoulders in your back pockets, hips way back, dig your heels and all 10 toes into the floor, and just pretend like you're gonna get up. If everything's feeling good and you want, squat or stand and tap, or stand and get your hips back into your deepest comfortable squat triple flexion. If it feels good, you can add those upright rows or your kettlebell front lateral raises, or you can alternate. This feels good. It should feel like work. Breathing. But it should feel like good work. If it doesn't feel like good work, or you've come to the end of your momentary muscular fatigue, good. That's where you are making a difference. I'm sweating. To think I was freezing when we started this series. Okay, hang your weights up. Time to get a sip of water. Stepping to the side. Pulling the navel in and leaning to the side. These great habits are things that we will just do with so much less effort if we, you know, just get into that routine. And I'm telling you, a routine is good because it helps you stay on track. It makes it easier. And that's why we have to change the exercises a little. Because even if you did the same ones every day and you didn't have any problems, you probably wouldn't get the most out of your exercise program, and you might overdo some muscles. So we like to change it a little. Here's to remaining flexible with your exercise, your mind, your body, and your spirit. Okay, well, we're gonna have to work on our agility and balance and aerobic strength. Aerobic means with oxygen, so we're strengthening our heart and our lungs predominantly. But the good news is whenever we do aerobic activity, it's great for our circulation, it's great for reducing stress, and it's great for cognitive health. Your brain needs oxygen every single minute, so breathe. Whether you're seated or standing, get yourself where you want to be. I'm going to demonstrate this single double pattern in the chair first. If you're standing, you want to be over to the right side of your chair, please. I'm going to turn that music up a tiny bit. If you're seated, at the front edge of your seat allows you to move and sit actively. Seated or standing, best posture, single, double knee lift. You can add those arms, big or little. Breathe and move. You can do whatever pattern at whatever pace you like, just so long as you keep moving at your pace. Single, double. Now if you're standing and you feel a little wobbly on that double, you got your chair in your left hip pocket, but you can also tap your toe down on that double. Yeah? Okay. Excellent. Breathing, moving. Excellent. All right, we're gonna do it a little bit faster if you like. Here we go. Single lift. March lift. Or step lift. Step lift. Single double. Single double. Single double. Keep going. I'm gonna transition to my feet. Single double. Single double. Single double. It doesn't have to be big. Now, only if you wish, we can make it double time. Single double. Single double. Small movements. Move those arms. Breathe. Single double. Stay where you're at. I'm gonna come closer so you can see my feet. Got it? Single double. We're going back. Stay at your chair, please. How about two more? Good. March it out. Take a deep breath. Assess your intensity. 1 to 10. How you doing? Can you talk? Yes? No? Maybe so? Well, we're going to try that again, but we're going to move with our hamstring curls behind our chair, sort of a hip width stance, this, and keeping our knee down so we can use those rear leg muscles. Starting a little triple flexion, and we'll do a single, double hamstring curl. Keeping the foot dorsiflex helps to recruit or use your hamstrings a little bit better. Single, double. Single, you can add bicep curls or not. You can keep your both arms on your chair, or you can add both arms oppositional. Good. I hope you're feeling good. Excellent. A little dip in your knees. Keep those knees soft. And you'll be getting more blood going by utilizing your thighs and hips more. Single, double. Remember, you got your chair, or you can tap your toe down if you need for that balance check. Now we've been going at tempo. If you like, we can try double time. Single, double. Tap, step, lift. Step, lift. Step, lift. Step, lift. You don't have to jump. Just shift your weight. Right, left, lift. Right, lift. Keep going. I'm going to come out there so you can see what I'm doing with my feet. Single, double. Step, lift. Step, lift. It won't be in everybody's wheelhouse, but if you wanted to, we could try this even faster. steps up, lift, steps up, lift. Just for those who feel good and want to try it. Make it little, but make it quick, quick feet. Single, single, double. Two more. Good, just march it out. How you doing? You doing all right? I hope so. Want to keep going? Yes, no, maybe so. You can do it in your chair. You can take a momentary break and then keep moving wherever you're at your pace. But let's bring it over to the left side. And let's try it with a little kick. Maybe kick, kick, double. Or straight legs, it's up to you. Think jump rope. You can keep one hand on your chair if you need that balance check. Single, single. Double, if you like, sort of come up to the ball of your foot or put a little flex in that knee, keeping it soft. Good, if your balance is good, you can bring it to both arms. Single, single, double. Good, I hope you feel good. Double, single, single, double. Let's do two more at tempo and then if you want, you can go a little faster. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Red, hot, pepper. Remember when you jumped rope? You can never miss with your imaginary jump rope. Now, it's not in everybody's desirable speed range, but if you wanted to go even faster, try it. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Yeah, you got the picture. Woo! How you doing? 1 to 10, where are you now? Hopefully right smack dab in the middle with that healthy heart range. Where is that heart? There it is. Okay, we're gonna transition to strength again. This time we're gonna use our rubber band. Ta-da! We're gonna use our seat pretty much the whole time. So before you get seated, put your heels right smack dab against the chair. You can double up your band if you want. Roll your shoulders into your back pockets, please, and get your hips back as you bring your hands forward. Maybe just freeze. Be mindful of your weight. Where is it? Is it in all 10 toes and both heels? Good. Bring your sits bones to the seat. Step to the side, lean to the side, have a little water. Check my notes. Make sure I'm on track with what we're doing here. Yes. Yeah, as I said, we're going to be in our chair pretty much the whole time. We're going to do a little bit of core work and a lot of upper body work. You'll always have options to do one or the other, do both together, or do neither. So, wherever you are, whatever you choose to do, sit actively near the front edge of your chair so we can activate these abdominals. You'll want to keep your band doubled up in your lap or just loosely, no tension yet, in your hands. Take your long, strong, straight, tallest spine and pull your navel in as if you're zipping up your tightest trousers and tuck your tailbone under like a sort of a scared puppy dog. Not that I want that, but you know. Lean your heart back until you feel gravity acting against your strong abdominals. Good. Now we're going to tuck our chin and then slide forward just a couple inches. Slide back. Keeping the tension on these abdominals, bracing and breathing. Ideally, exhale on the way up, inhale on the way back, and repeat. Or the opposite of that, but don't hold your breath. So that's our core exercise. Hopefully you feel it. Sometimes I feel better when my knees are together. It takes the tension off other muscles. So you can try that, or you can try hip width stance. It's up to you. Now, we're gonna take a shoulder width stance or grip on our band, so just hold it out there. Wrists straight, see how that feels. And we're gonna add a one-armed row to our right as we go back. Like you're Cupid drawing back your bow. Then your left. Keep that navel pulling in strong. Keep the back of the neck long. Do your best. Now, to make this easier, you could just do one length of the band or hold more space between your hands. Today, I'm dressed in pink and I've got a heart on and talking about heart health because I'm recording this on Valentine's Day. And by the time you see it, it's already going to be the end of February, thereabouts. But every day is a good day to love yourself, love somebody else, and take good care of your heart and all of your other muscles, okay? All right, now transitioning, we're gonna work on, that was for our upper back and biceps, our abdominals. Let's take that band behind our chest, up right underneath our armpits, scooch way back in your chair so that if you choose, you can add a little leg extension. So let's get this chest press going. We want to have enough tension that we feel it here on the front of the chest and the shoulders. Oh, I see one of my friends at the front door. So we're going to grab that band and push. Good. Our spine is and our hips are well back in our chair. So if you want, with this platform of the chair under our thighs, you can add a right leg extension and a left leg extension. Pull the navel in. That's kind of hard. Make it as challenging as you need. And if you want, after this leg extension, let's try a little right pulse and climb up a ladder with that little pulse to our shoulders and come on down. Woo! I felt that on the tops of my thighs. And then the left. And right back down. That was a coordination conundrum. All right, one more exercise. Easy with your jump rope. Flip it. Or just let go of one end and bring it to the front of your body. Scoot your hips to the front edge of your chair. Step on the band, equal length on either side of the knees. Crisscross your handles so that you have a letter X between your legs. Make enough space between your feet that you can comfortably roll your shoulders into your back pockets and pull those handles close to your abdominal area. From here, shoulders down and back, we're going to row, squeezing those shoulders back, and then lower. Inhale up, exhale down, or vice versa. No wrong way to breathe, so long as you're not holding your breath. Now, if you want, we can add a hip abduction to the right, to the left. One leg at a time, please, folks. Keep the torso strong and long and stable right in the middle. That keeping your body still, that anti-rotation, anti-leaning is a very important job of your spine stabilizing muscles. Make sure you breathe. Right about now, it should be getting hard. If it's not challenging you, it's still good for you. But it's good if you challenge yourself ever so slightly. And do your best, maybe one more each side. I'm running out of gas. Wow. How about you? Are you running out of gas? The good news about our body's energy systems is if we eat right, sleep right, we'll have more energy the next time in general when it's time to exercise. So we're gonna hang up our tube. Let's get a sip of water. I think I forgot to prompt you to do that in between the last two intervals. Oy vey! You know you. when you're thirsty, especially whenever you're seated, that's a good time to be mindful and really take your time as you step to the side, lean to the side to get anything down low. Slower, mindful movements in general are going to be far less risky. Be prepared, not scared. And this time of year, as I look out at the ice and the snow, a lot of folks, all ages, rightfully so, get worried about slipping and falling on the snow or the ice. But be prepared, not scared. Work on your balance, assess the risks, and if you feel like the risks outweigh the benefits, there'll be much better weather coming soon. But right now, it's up to you. Okay, so one way to reduce your risks of falls is to practice balance. Whoops. I'm trying to turn that music down. So, our bodies in general use three different sources of input to balance better. I'm going to come close and tell you, you can stay in your seat. We use predominantly vision. That's input to our brain. Our brain is sort of like the air traffic control tower of our body. So that visual input to the brain is very dominant in those of us who have sight. Some of us don't, or our vision is impaired. So the next source of information that our brain gets is our vestibular inner ear information from the three semicircular canals in there. And it tells us pitch, yaw, and roll. And sometimes those systems get messed up. And so they're not the best input anymore. The third set of input to our body, to our brain, which then tells our body how to better balance, is our they're called proprioceptive cells, and they're in no more dense places than your ankles and your joints. So we're going to intentionally take one of those systems away, our vision, so that we can better hone and practice our vestibular or inner ear and our proprioception. But we gotta do it safely. So behind your chair, or I'm gonna step to the side so you can see what I'm doing. Best posture. This is slow, easy. Well, simple, not easy. Standing in your neutral stance with your ankles right under your hips, just breathe, relax, feel the weight grounded in both feet. And with your eyes open in your best posture and your left hand or both hands, just a millimeter or a fingernail's breadth away, promise me, from your chair, see how it feels to draw little circles with your body so that you feel your weight shifting to all parts of your feet, kind of like a mime or a Marcel Marceau kind of feeling. You can go the other way. Breathing, warming up your feet and ankles. Good. Now, see how that feels, keeping your hand a millimeter away from your chair with your eyes closed, knowing you can open them, or you could grab your chair, or you could step out into a mini squat. Those are our anti-fall or our fall prevention tools in our toolkit. So now, best posture if you wish, hand a millimeter away from your chair, close your eyes, and if you feel confident, you could add those little body circles. Knowing you can open your eyes whenever you like, switching directions if you like with your body circles. Good. For some of us, that's going to be pretty simple, pretty easy. So to make it challenging, more challenging, put your feet together. Try the same exercise. And then with your eyes closed, try your body circles. This is also strengthening our feet and our ankles. Keep that hand a millimeter away from your chair. Don't go like this. There's no imaginary sky bars to grab, okay? And make sure you take it the other way with your body circles. If you want to make it much more challenging, you could try a staggered stance, toe to heel. This is where it really gets hard. So keep your hand where? A millimeter away from your chair. Best posture. This time, let's just shift our weight forward and back with eyes open. And then if you wish, close the eyes. Shift your weight forward and back, knowing you've got your chair and you can open your eyes. Another strategy is to step out. Try it with the other foot in front, if that's in your safe, comfortable zone of challenge. First with eyes open, testing the waters as you shift your weight, keeping all parts of the feet on the floor. And then if you feel confident, you can close your eyes. Will this exercise help you with your eyes open? Yes, it'll strengthen your feet and your ankles. With your eyes closed, it will really help hone your inner ear and your proprioceptive information feedback to your brain. One last exercise here in our staggered stance. If you want to come up to tippy toes, tuck your tailbone under and balance, strengthening your calves. Ah, good. Switch your other foot to the front. Get your balance. Lengthen your body. Keep your hand how far away from your chair? A millimeter. And come up to your tiptoes. Now, those of you who wanted to, you may have figured it out. You could close your eyes. Woo! But I felt wobbly there. But that's the whole point, is to feel a little wobbly, but knowing you can open your eyes, grab your chair, and step out. While we're standing, if you're standing, let's get a calf stretch, and then we'll finish off with some seated stretches. So walk that right foot back little by little till you've got it where you could pace the heel on the ground and lean forward. Ah, if you feel good, you can stretch that right arm up, stretch through the right side. And then release, relax, and gradually walk that left foot back to a place where you could pace that heel on the ground. It must be close to 5 o'clock because my lovely little kitty couch potato, who likes to sleep during the day, is getting ready for her next meal. She's really got a good routine, that cat. Oh, she just circled. In 5 minutes, she'll get her meal. Heel on the ground, leaning forward. If you wanted and you feel stable, you could stretch that left arm up. But if you need your chair, that's okay. I think our latest addition to the family, our little kitty cat, Warren, has kept me from going a little bit stir crazy. All right, let's get seated however you want. So feet close to the chair ensures you won't miss and hit the floor, which is really not desirable as you get seated, because you never know when your knee is going to give out. You never know when you're going to fall until you're just about to fall. Sometimes you don't even know until you're on the ground. So, but a practice of prevention is really, really a great strategy. First of all, it keeps you active to practice fall prevention, and it keeps you engaged. As you look around your home, you may want to assess the home for fall risks. And if you're not sure about that, you can call or go to the website of the Green County Council on Aging. But there's all kinds of resources out there, including the CDC, Centers for Disease Control, and SteadyU, S-T-E-A-D-I-U, through the state of Ohio. Whatever you do for fall prevention, the thing that will work best is the thing you do. So have a little plan, work the plan, and enjoy the benefits. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. So let's stretch out the fronts of these thighs and hips that worked very hard when we did these leg extensions and our knee lifts. Hip flexors and quadriceps tend to be very tight in most folks. So turning your body to the right side, left hip just a little bit off the chair. Hinging forward slow so you don't get a hamstring cramp. It helps to hinge forward, supporting with this left arm to get that leg back just as far as is comfortable and relax that leg. Let the knee drift down, lengthening here. Let the head drift up, lengthening here. If it's comfortable, let the arm drift up. Open your spine, slight gentle arch if it feels good. And then exhale and lean towards your chair. Stretch. Oh, that feels good. Remember, if it doesn't feel good, substitute your favorite stretch. But remember, variety is good. We want to get as many of our different muscles more flexible. Greater flexibility and greater strength around our joints reduces our risk of injuries. Honest to goodness. I hear the automatic feeder. Did you see that? Some of you have told me that you thought I had a stuffed animal on my couch. No, no, no. Turning to the left side, left hip ever so slightly off the front of your chair. Remember, support your spine, take your time. Hinging forward allows you to get that right leg back. Whether your toe is tucked under or just pointing slightly towards that opposite wall behind you, relax the leg, relax the foot, let the knee drift down. Inhale as the body, crown of the head and arm may drift upward. And gentle, gentle, slight arch in your back. Nothing should hurt. If you've been told not to do that by your healthcare providers or your orthopedic surgeon, or your back said, not today, don't do it. And exhale as you stretch through your left side. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's ease out of that. Facing forward, ease your hips into the back of your chair. I'm going to put these things down so that they're not in my way. Get a sip of water if you like. We're going to focus on breathing. We're going to focus on our heart. As I said near the beginning of the month, February is Heart Health Month. Maybe because Valentine's Day is already there. And February is Dental Health Month. I'm not sure why. And February is Black History Month. But every month is good to pay attention to all three of those things. So every little thing we do makes a positive difference and makes other things easier. So open up your heart, open up your mind, open up your mouth, brush your teeth, and just relax. Sit back, make sure your spine's supported, your neck and shoulders are relaxed. Rest your hands in your lap and just breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth at your own pace. As you breathe in, think of filling your beautiful big pink lungs from the bottom to the top. And as you breathe out, the lungs will naturally, efficiently, effortlessly deflate from the top to the bottom. Try it. Inhale. Every in-breath, I want you to think of the life-giving oxygen entering your body like a glow of light warming your heart. And every exhale, let that light radiate out and share your joy, your joie de vivre, your passion, even your sorrow, share it with others. But keep breathing. Keep practicing positive thinking. Preventative health. And safety, health, safety, hygiene practices. So important. And if we develop them like habits, it'll become easier. And the good news is this one good health habit will make other aspects of our health better. Just as understanding some parts of history help us to understand other parts of history, nothing's really on an island by itself, is it? No. So, the more you know, the better you will be able to find out more. And I found, as I get older, the more I know, the more I realize I don't know. So, let's all keep learning. Let's all keep it safe and simple. Bye for now. See you soon.